Well, good morning, everybody, and thanks for joining us here on the web. We begin with a big day in politics here in New Hampshire. Both presidential candidates, Mitt Romney and President Obama, will be in New Hampshire today. The president will visit Strawberry Bank in Portsmouth. He will be joined by the First Lady, the Vice President, Joe Biden, and Dr. Jill Biden as well. Doors open at 10 a.m., and tickets are required to attend. The event is expected to get underway shortly after noontime. Meantime, as for Mitt Romney's visit tonight, he will host a rally at Holman Stadium in Nashua. That event starts at 7 o'clock. The doors open at about 4:30 p.m. The Republican candidates for governor got their chance to face off last night in our Granite State debates, and they both say there is more to the job than a high approval rating.
Governor Lynch does have a high approval rating, but I'm not running for governor to be Mr. Congeniality. I'm running for governor, to lead.
I'll be there at natural disasters and state celebrations, but I'll also be leading.
Ovid LaMontagne and Kevin Smith went head-to-head on a number of important issues facing our state, including taxes, jobs, health care, the Northern Pass Project, and same-sex marriage. But it all started when both candidates were asked why they should be the next governor of New Hampshire.
I have real-world business leadership experience as a business lawyer and an advocate, as a business owner. And I've served in, as a chairman of the State Board of Education, as legal counsel of the State Senate, in government, and I've been involved with our civic and charitable world. And I can take all these three sectors and the experience I have based on my conservative principles to bring us to a new era of prosperity here in New Hampshire.
I've been casting a long-term vision with a specific economic plan for how we're going to make New Hampshire into the most economically competitive state in the country. It's a plan that lowers taxes on all businesses, reduces the cost of health care, brings down our electric rates, retains more young people here in the state of New Hampshire, and makes state government more accountable to the taxpayers.
Now, if you missed any parts of our Granite State debates, you can watch it all on our website here, WMUR.com. You can also check out where the candidates stand on the issues in the Commitment 2012 section of our politics page. And on our Facebook page, you can grade the candidates on their performance in those debates. Parents in Dover are on edge this morning after at least one man exposed himself to two girls on two separate occasions. The first incident happened Wednesday morning at a bus stop on Bellamy Road. A student at Woodman Park School was waiting for the bus when a man, who police say was naked from the waist down, pulled up next to her and asked her if she wanted a ride. The second incident happened yesterday afternoon on Alumni Drive. A middle school student was walking home when a man pulled up with the same M.O.
I think it's terrible. I think it's terrible that our kids' school is just starting and now they're having to worry about this.
Well, these are very scary incidents and we're very concerned for everybody's safety.
Both girls got away unharmed. The descriptions they gave of the suspects are not the same. So right now, police do not know if they are searching for one suspect or two different men. A longtime member of the Fisher Cats is getting a call up to the big leagues tonight.
I'm Alex James. On behalf of the entire Fisher Cat staff, I'd like to thank you all for attending today's game.
PA announcer Alex James will be behind the microphone tonight at Fenway Park when the Red Sox open a series with the Blue Jays. James has been the voice of Northeast Delta Dental Stadium for the last 5 years, and last year was on the short list to become the PA announcer for the Chicago Cubs at Wrigley Field. Wishing him best of luck. That's it for this webcast. We hope you can join us for News Night at Noon, and you can check out our next webcast around 1 this afternoon. Have a great day, everybody.